Welcome to Session 7 of the Excel 2013 Essential Skills video course. Excel has a range of tools that will allow you to present your work as polished and professional printed reports. This session will give you all of the skills you need to control every aspect of printing your work on paper. This 5-minute preview is designed to enable you to quickly review all of the skills you're going to master in Session 7. If you already have some Excel experience, this 5-minute preview may enable you to skip over some or all of the lessons in this session. So, let's start the clock ticking and begin the preview. In the first lesson, you're going to print preview a worksheet. That's a way of seeing it exactly as it will appear on the printed paper. You're then going to change the orientation from portrait to landscape. And then you learn how to add a button to the quick access toolbar so that you can print preview with a single click in future. In the second lesson, you'll use page layout view. Up to now, you've been using normal view, but page layout view allows you to adjust margins. After you've entered page layout view, you'll learn how to add rulers to the top and left of the view. You'll then change the ruler units from inches to centimetres and use the rulers to set a left margin. In the third lesson, you'll use page setup to set margins more precisely. You'll begin by looking at the preset margins available, and then you'll set a custom margin so that the margins are precisely 1 centimetre. Then you're going to look at centering the worksheet on the printout. On this printed page, the left margin is narrower than the right margin. So we'll use Excel's centering facility to make the margins of equal sizes. In the fourth lesson, you'll address a common Excel problem. That's when the printout won't print on a single sheet of paper. And you'll change this printout, that's split across 2 sheets, into this printout that prints on a single sheet. You'll explore 2 ways of doing this. The first is to change the paper size, and the second is to scale the printout so that it fits onto 1 sheet of paper. In the fifth lesson, you'll insert, delete, and preview page breaks. Page breaks are shown by dotted lines, showing you where Excel will move to a new sheet of paper. And you can see that, in this case, there's a vertical page break that's splitting the chart in two. You'll learn how to adjust the page breaks so that the chart's printed on 1 sheet of paper. The sixth lesson introduces page break preview. Page break preview allows you to change page breaks by clicking and dragging on the page break lines. In the seventh lesson, you'll add simple headers and footers. You'll begin by adding the page number as a header and the name of the workbook as a footer. Then you'll change the number at which numbering begins to number 10. In the eighth lesson, you'll add more sophisticated headers and footers. You'll begin by understanding the concept of an escape character and a field name, and then you'll use this knowledge to construct this more sophisticated header, showing the printed date and time, the page number, and the name of the report. In the ninth lesson, you'll learn how to create a cover page. That's a page that appears at the beginning of a report. And you'll notice that the page header is spoiling its appearance. So you'll learn how to suppress the page header, but only for the cover page, and also how to put different headers and footers on the even pages and odd pages of your report. This is very useful when you're printing on both sides of the printed page. In the 10th lesson, you'll print only part of a worksheet. You'll learn 2 techniques to do this. The first by printing a selection, and the second by setting a print area. In the 11th lesson, you'll address a very common Excel problem when printing, and that is to print the column headers at the top of each page in the printout. In this lesson, you'll learn how to do this. Then you'll learn how to produce this printed page. That's showing printed grid lines, as well as printed letters across the top of each column, and printed row numbers to the left of each row. In the 12th lesson, you'll consider page order. You can see that this page order is down then over. That means you go from page 1 down to page 2, then over to page 3. You'll learn how to change this to over and down, meaning page 1, over to page 2, over to page 3, then down to page 4. In the 13th lesson, you'll learn how to suppress error messages. This worksheet has two divide by zero errors, but you'll learn how to print it so that the errors show as blank spaces. And as with all sessions, at the end of the session, there's a session exercise, so that you can test yourself on the new skills learned. And you're now ready to begin Session 7, Printing Your Work.